Hallå, god morgon. Om det är spelet alltså. God middag om det är i live. God natt om det är någon annanstans i världen. Good. I hope you have a nice day. Now I'm going to drive. No, they are going away. I'm going from, as you can see, Vasa to Gudrad with this asphalt miller on 44 ton. So I better start driving. I just stopped with a diesel station and filled up my tank, or the truck's tank, with some diesel. Oh, I can see my translation is okay. Trafiken här är gles med noll spelare online. I just changed that information. That was very good, because I thought it was wrong before. I hope you have a very, very, very good day, and Happy New Year. It is 2021. I think it was terrible, terrible, terrible what's happened in Washington this night. I am not going to talk political, but I thought I shall tell you what I'm thinking. It was terrible. Terrible, terrible. Hello, Swede. Your mic is off. God morgon, god morgon.
Morgon, morgon.
Ja, du såg ju vad som hände igår.
Jag vet inte om man ska skratta eller gråta åt det.
Alltså, vi ska ju inte prata politik, men jag tycker att det här är fruktansvärt gjort utav en viss person.
Ja, det förstör hela landet för dem.
Ja. Och det kommer ju bli förhoppningsvis repressalier, men de funderar ju på någon paragraf 20 eller vad det var.
Ja, avsätta honom.
25 kanske var. Förlåt mig. Nej, var det 20 eller 25? Jag kommer inte
ihåg. Ja, nej, jag tror det är 25.
25, ja. Men de tror inte att de kommer att hinna. Men jag tycker de ska göra ett försök i alla fall.
Ja.
Ja, ja. Här är det 4 grader kallt ute. Har snöat lite grann i natt. Så att det är vitt och fint ute.
Men, ja, det har kommit några flingor här också.
Ja.
Det var vid minnesrätt.
Ja. Är du och kör nu eller har du kommit fram?
Jag har kört lite. Lite single-player.
Ja. Ja, jag kör alltid multiplayer. Jag tycker det är roligast. Jag har lite riktigt folk bredvid mig, så att säga.
Och jag vill på det.
Och jag är ju nu på väg till från Vasa. Nej, där kan jag köra. Och in i Ryssland nu faktiskt. Jag kan visa kartan här under tiden jag blir checkad. Här är jag nu. Kotka, utanför Kotka. Precis. Vad sa du?
Jag håller på att logga in precis här nu. Så
ja. Mm.
Ja, var du uppe länge i natt eller?
Ja, klockan blev ju 3:15 innan jag la på luren.
Okej. Okay.
Så, ser du var jag är nu någonstans?
Nej, jag kan inte göra det, ladda spelet.
Ja, jag är på väg mot Viborg, om man säger så.
Jaha, okej. Okay. Det var det vi kom från igår.
Var det det?
Ja, men var... Jag var inte i Viborg.
Ja, kanske det var det. Nej, Vasa stannade tidigt.
Ja, men vi åkte från Viborg.
Ja, det kanske det var.
Så att det var uppdateringen både på ETS och ATS, jag vet inte vad.
Jag har uppdaterat tracker lite igen. Jag gjorde så att du jobbade lite igen igår kväll och idag nu på fixar jag till en sak också bara för 10 minuter sedan.
Jaha.
Där man kör in och de skriver att trafiken är snabb. Så jag ändrar till trafiken är gles och det funkar på en gång. Men jag kommer inte ihåg vad nästa steg heter, om den är normal eller om den är slow eller vad 17 då man kallar det för. Men jag tycker det är bättre att man skriver att den är gles, att trafiken är gles. Än att den är snabb.
Det låter lite...
Så jag översatte, jag satt en timme översatt igår lite grann.
Men det är ju samma om det skulle komma att den trafiken är långsam. Det,
och, ja, det är det inte, den är tät då, kan man skriva kanske.
Tät, precis, ja.
Jag vet inte hur många steg det är, om det är 2 eller 3 steg eller om det bara är gles eller tät, jag vet inte.
Jo, en sak som jag märkte, det kanske var från den nya uppdateringen, det vet jag inte, men när jag började få slut på bränsle,
ja,
då stod det att det stod inte diesel utan stod AD Blue.
AD Blue, jaha. Ja. Men det är inte track utan det är...
Det var ju spelet alltså.
Spelet, ja, ja, ja. Jag har aldrig hört talas om AD Blue faktiskt.
Nej, det är ju en speciell dieseltyp.
Är det någon miljövänlig diesel?
Ja, typ.
Åh, då kör vi miljövänligt då!
Ja.
Ja. Och så ändrar jag...
Nu vet inte jag om det hörs här på... Om det är Discord eller inte, men... ibland låter det nästan som att det skulle... Som att högtalarna borde... Bruckna nästan, eller så skrapigt.
Okej. Okay. Jag vet inte om det är jag som pratar kanske lite högt, men nu pratar jag lite gärna mer normalt.
För det är lite att du försvinner ibland också, för mig i alla fall.
Är det när jag ser du, nu åker jag in i Viborg, trafiken här i gles med 0 spelare online.
Ja, det var glest. Ja, det kanske är när du har in.
Om jag tar i, är det sådär?
Ja, då är det nästan så att det stryps på något sätt.
Ja, men om jag pratar så här lite lugnt då?
Jag tror att du får gå in i inställningar på Discord och kolla på det sen.
Ja, men...
Och jämföra vad jag har och du har.
Ja, men jag kan stanna till här. Så sätter jag på varningsblinker sen så.
Så. Det tar sån tid att ladda.
F, varningsblinkers.
Och då var det klart.
Allt tabbar jag ut här och sen går jag på inställningarna. För att använder inställningar och då går vi till röst och video. Inmatningsenhet, då kanske jag kan ta mikrofon på headset. Är det bättre nu då? Det var lite fel tror jag. Ingångsvolym tar jag i mitten.
Inmatnings- och utmatnings, det har jag ju.
Eller tar jag hörluren. Ja,
min mikrofon så att säga. Headset.
Nu har jag headsetet på båda och jag har...
Och det försvinner du, det hör knappt någonting vad du säger.
Okej, okay, hör du något bättre nu?
Inte mycket.
1, 2, 3. Jag tittar på ingångskänsligheten, den pikar i max här. Om jag slår av den där, blir det bättre nu?
Ja, men när jag pratar så går det... Det går i max också. Men du har den ikopplad eller?
Vilken då?
Att den är ingångskänslighet, att den är på grön så att säga.
Ja. Har du den här knappen på ingångskänsligheten, har du den aktiverad eller inte?
Den är aktiverad.
Aktiverad? Okej, då har jag ju bock där då.
Mm,
och hur mycket har du ingångsvolymen till?
Ingångsvolymen.
Högre upp där det står inmatningsenhet.
Jag har max på allting.
Du har max på allting. Nu har jag max på allting där också.
Det lät det bättre. Nu hörde det bättre.
Ja, så de har jag på max och sen har jag då ibockat ingångskänsligheten.
Brus.
Vänta lite, kameran är ju den, ja. Vad man ser, brusreduceringen har jag ibockad.
Mm.
Det var videokoliken. Eko har jag ibockad. Brusminskning går inte att bocka i.
Nej.
Avancerad röst ibockad. Förstärkningskontrollen ibockad.
Aktivera hög prioritet, det har jag inte ibockat.
Inte jag heller. Dämpning har jag minimum.
Du försvinner ibland. Jag hör knappt alls vad du säger.
Jag har minimum på dämpningen.
Dämpning är på längst till vänster och när jag talar är inte ibockad. När andra talar ibockad står det.
Ja, stamma här.
Och sen ja, standard. Röstdiagnostik inte. I bocket på första.
Okej, det hade jag. Då slår vi av den.
Använd vår senaste teknik i bockad. Remetell i bockad. Sen är det för felstyrkning. Det är ju två stycken som är inte i bockade.
Då har vi likadant nu. Exakt likadant du och jag.
Ja.
Jaha.
Vid den till din mikrofon börjar jag sig.
Jag vet inte. Jag
hoppas.
Nu har vi vikt här. Hello. All is good. Yes, all is good. We have problem with the microphone. We are testing now here only. Ja, men då kör vi vidare på det här då. Får vi hoppas att det fungerar. Bättre.
Ja.
Så.
Då låste sig mitt spelverk. Ja.
Slitt också. Hallå Victor. Eller Victor. I think it's Victor. As you see I'm going from Vasa now with Asphalt Miller. And I have a long way to go, close to 1,300 kilometers. And it's a long way. Me and Mr. Sweet talking about my microphone. He said it is sometimes it's a problem to hear me. I'm disappearing when I'm talking. Maybe it when I'm talking a little loud, maybe. So I'm not going to whisper, but I'm going to talk a little more quiet than usual. When I'm exciting, I'm starting to talk a little louder. I have to.
Du har ingen annan typ av ljudgrejs i närheten som kan störa, eller?
Nej, jag har ju kameran framför, men den har jag inte valt som en ljudenhet.
Nej, för ibland så är det nästan som det var förr i tiden, att om du har en mobil för nära så... Inte att det blippar så, eller som det gjorde förr, men just det är något... Nästan metalliskt.
Hallå, Gnabbis, välkommen.
Lite grann i bakgrunden. Uh-huh. Nu pratar jag ju bra. Men jag hörs bra.
Om jag gör så här. Jag knäpper med fingrarna bredvid micken, bredvid kameran. Och så här. Men jag tror att du hör mig via mikrofonen här på headsetet. Och inte via kamerans mikrofon. Gnabbis say, there is a slight metallic buzz or rattle to your microphone signal, yes. Okay. Why? My headset is connected by a USB. And I had changed for this... I have changed the input USB to another USB, and I can change it back to what it was before. But I have to it takes some time, so if you stand by, I will disconnect my microphone and connect it as before. So stand by, please.
And like you said, when he talks a little bit high voice, it can really hear it. du säger detta hör det metallic sound for the moment right now. Am I? I talk a little bit lower. Talk a little bit more, please. Ja, det får jag säga. Or maybe that interfered from some other stuff then. But I have my headset. No, I have it through a hub actually. I forgot to change in Discord or what?
So now it should be better. Sorry, Gnabist. Sorry. I have to change it in the OBS also. So now it's better. It should be better now. Ah, perfect. Now I have learned many things here. Don't connect the headset to a USB hub. It's not good. Connect directly into the computer. And when you do so, change the input settings in OBS. Oh, yes. I hope you're having a nice day, everyone. This is a learning thing for me also. But now I think everything works good. Thank you, Gnavist. I have it very loudly in my ears now. My output volume is very, very high. I have to change it, sorry, but I have to change my headset's air for... It is too loudly. What? What sa du? Ja, vänta lite. Please, vänta. Min ingångsvolym är...
noterar att jag har din användarvolym är på 200% i min här.
Ja, okej. Okay. Jag...
Så. Nu är det okej för mig i alla fall.
Okej, okay. Jag hoppas att det är bra. Den står på 90% nu i inmatningsenheten på Discord. I står den på 90%. Och utgångs är ju på 100 då. Så. Det är en svårt. Okay, now I hope it will works for everyone. And I hope I can hear you also, Mr. Swede. And Gnabbist, tell me that rebalancing source is good. Thank you. I thought it worked connecting to the USB hub, but it doesn't. But now it's good. A couple of other guys, and you can pause. Go before me. You go before me. So now they are gone. So, the weather in Sweden for you, if you are interested, it's 4 degrees cold at my place, and it has been snowing a little this night, but now it's not snowing. We have a little mountain. It's only 170 meters high here. I think it is so. And they have a ski slope on it, and they are using the snow cannon to get a better for the skier. Yeah, I'm not going through Helsinki, I think.
I'm going, I think it's, I saw where you going, so maybe, I think it's a town just to the west.
Okay.
Good, so maybe we will meet up somewhere.
Yeah. I'm not going to take the ferry from Helsinki, and I'm going around the Finska Viken. I don't know what it is called in English, but Finska Viken, we say in Sweden.
I think, is it called peninsula?
I don't know.
Swedish
then. Yeah. Vik. Bay. Finnish Bay. I don't know in English what the name is. I'm very sure that Gnab is just now looking it up in the maps.
by the way, Peninsula is no.
It's a lot of islands, I think peninsula means.
Ja, halvö tror jag.
Halvö, okej. No, I'm coming to the big bridge here. And if you are, talking to my people here in this stream, if you land leaking out into the water from the large land mass is peninsula. Yeah, yeah. But you know where Helsinki is, and you have a big bay. No, not bay, what you called?
Yeah, I think it's called bay.
You go around in Russia, not to take the ferry. I can stop here, and I have lots of time, no hurry for me, and I'll show you on the map.
It's called bay.
Yeah.
Bay is right. Or inlet, or...
You see, this is water, Grabis. All this is water, and you can take the ferry from Helsinki to Tallinn, but if you go around here, we call this the Finska Viken, the Finnish something. What do you call this in the English? I don't know. This water something. Ser du på min stream, Swede? Where is the living? Okay, I can show you. I'm living here I live, in Sweden, north of Sundsvall and south of Övik. Yep, inlet, Grabby said. Bay inlet sounds lots of English word. Okay. Bay, can we say though? The Finnish bay. Okay.
When I don't know, I think we can meet up in Riga.
Okay. I hope I'm driving through Riga. I have to look. I don't know.
I think so.
Yeah, I will take my map and look here. I'm going outside St. Petersburg and down to Luga and to Pskov.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going by P23 road. P23.
Did I say the wrong name to you? I think it was.
Yeah, it's very pretty in Sweden, in north of Sweden. I live about in the middle. Little north about the middle of the Sweden, and it's very beautiful here, and also in south of Sweden where Mr. Swede lives, it's very beautiful.
It's not on the map though, but
yeah. And if you want to see some videos from my town, look up citylooksweden.se. CityLookSweden.se. There I have lots of videos from my town. It's a 5 year old videos, but you can look it if you want.
How far have you left?
I have 1119 kilometers.
Okay, I have 1136.
Oh yeah,
but I do have a ferry.
Okay. I have a heavy load asphalt miller, 44 ton. Can you see I have added ton after the weight of the truck? Victor, I am from Denmark and we have a summer house close to the Swedish town called Tingsryd, which is like an hour away from Växjö. Nice! Very, very nice. And it is closer to Mr. Swede and me, I can tell you. I live...
Yeah, it might be... It'll be... 2.5-3 hours back home.
Yeah, yeah. And if I want to take my car and go south to Stockholm, to example, it will take about 5 hours with my car. With no rest. About 5 hours. So I live at the east coast of Sweden. Now we have cold and little snow here, and I love sitting inside my house. It's very beautiful up there. Yes, it is. I agree. We have a place north of us called the High Coast. It's an area where you can go if you want to see lots of ups and downs, road going up and down. You cannot drive fast in that area. And we have also north of me, about 20 kilometers north of me, we have a bridge, a big bridge called High Coast Bridge. And the view from that bridge is very, very, very nice.
Even in the game.
Yeah, even in the game, yes. Okay, in Denmark they got about 10 to 20 centimeters in one day. Oh, wow. That much. I have been into Denmark, I think, 3 times. And not by car, I got by the ferry. One time from Helsingborg and one time from Malmö. And it was a long time ago. And of course, we go to the circus, what do you call it, in Köpenhamn? Hjälp mig. Vad sa du?
Säger man inte cirkus?
Ja, men det är ju något speciellt det heter där nere. Jag har glömt bort namnet. It was an area where you can have fun.
Entertainment.
Yeah. It is not circus, it is another name, but I cannot remember. Sorry, I'm old.
I know what you mean, I've been there, but...
I've drained my memories, now I am... Now I'm coming into Luga. It's an amusement park, yes, of course. But it's I can't remember the name in Copenhagen, in what the name is. Everyone goes there and have fun. Drink beer.
Me and my daughter was there once and it was the worst.
Man, what foot don't hit the... I'm angry at myself, I can't remember. Okay, but Victor, in Köpenhamn, vad heter den nöjesparken, amusement park, nöjesparken i Köpenhamn, alla går till då. Jag har ju bilder på det där också, jag kommer inte ihåg vad det heter. När du säger det, Tivoli, yeah, good.
Circus or circus, it's in Stockholm.
Yeah. Tivoli. Yeah.
Thank you,
Victor. You made my day. It's so nice there.
You go. So mad, but you can't remember.
You go in there and drink a beer or so. I cannot go to the carousel. I cannot do that. It goes around and around and around and I feel sick. So I cannot do that.
Do you drink beer and then it go around?
Yeah. It's then not the carousel. Yeah. I can't do anything about it because I like beer. And I have coffee now. I forgot I have coffee. Made coffee just for this trip. Ah, good.
I just had a little drive on single player before.
Oh, yes.
But everyone else in Discord plays 7 Days to Die.
Oh, is it a popular game?
Yeah, that was the game we talked about.
Yeah.
But didn't.
Yeah.
No, thank you.
No, not for me either.
Oh, I do have coffee swell up on the table.
Yeah. You have to try Suegas Forza sometimes. It's a very good coffee.
My wife doesn't want to try that. I actually asked her, but nope. We stick to Gevalia.
Yeah. Maybe you can buy one, buy a little one and try it.
Yeah.
I think it's very good. And my son, now gone, he's like this also, and he learned me to drink Suegas. I drank...
Which one of Suegas?
Forza.
Okay.
Forza.
Forza Horizon.
And I was drinking Coop Dark coffee, and he said, no, that's not real coffee. You have to drink Suegas.
Okay.
Yeah. And every time I was at his house, he served coffee to me. And then I started to drink also, so I bought half a kilo, and loved it. And then he said, no, I have stopped drinking coffee. Why?
Okay.
No, I don't want to drink coffee, I drink tea. Okay, do you want to, I give you my Brewer. No, but it is yours. No, if you don't want it, I throw it away. No, 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 I take it. And it was a very good brewer. It was a Mocha Master. Okay. And he bought it for himself because the brewing temperature is perfect for brewing coffee. It cannot be too high and it cannot be too low. That was the perfect brewer. So now I'm drinking coffee too much, 4 cups sometime a day.
That's okay.
Yeah, I love it. It's so good. It's smooth, if I can say so.
Having a convoy with some other guy here.
Okay.
Seems to be a
now
French guy.
I'm coming to Ostrov. No, Pskov. I mean Pskov. Sorry. One player. I have to learn also how to make a traffic report. You can do that in the game also. For example, one truck is on the right side of the road standing still, and you can make a report of this, and when others come close to it, it warn you.
But then you should, then you have to stop and what?
I think so. Yeah, two times I have got some that report, and I also looked. You can also do a report about roadworks in the game. I don't know why, but you can.
Okay.
But the roadworks in the game are static, so they will not change, and it will not be a new one. Temporary. I don't know how they're thinking. No, yesterday night I was sitting up to over 3 o'clock looking at CNN, United States, CNN. I can do that. And it was not fun to see that. And sorry to report, it was 4 people dead. Mm-hmm. One woman I know about when I'm looking, she was shot.
Yeah, in the chest.
Yeah. And the other 3 I got noticed this morning when I wake up and look at the news. And they say that it was 4 of them.
Yeah, sure, it's sad, but on the other hand, they shouldn't be there.
No, exactly. It's unnecessary. They cannot change of the how it will be, and they tried. Ah, well, no politics. I'm only reporting about the casualties. Sorry. Think about the family for the dead one, family and friends.
Yeah.
Lost their dear one. And it's only one people to blame, but I don't say who.
I'm in Pärnu, and traffic is glass.
Nice, it works so quickly.
Yeah.
But in English it says something else, I think.
Is it slow, maybe, then?
I don't know.
Because if the traffic is fast, I think it was fast.
Yeah. And now you can also see about the nuvarande jobb. It is in ton, not a T.
Oh, that's the one. Okay. That's good.
That has changed also. It took a long time to find it, but then I found it.
Did you search for it?
Cannabis. Our traffic report from Mr. Swede is a picture of a helicopter. Yeah. We are talking about this trucky. It's an application you can load before you're starting the simulator.
Overlay,
yes. And it take all the data from the simulator and put it up on the screen. And it works very good, I will say.
Yeah.
And
you can also make your own transports.
Yeah.
Like the Speditor program.
Yeah, but in this software it's called the Dispatcher.
It's much better.
Yep. You don't have to restart the simulator a lot of time when you use a Speditor. Here you don't have to do it. And it works very, very, very good. If you choose the right save file. I can tell you are listening, if you are in a team doing a convoy, one of you choose the route and the trailer what you want to have, and then you're generating a special code you can share with the others, and they put it in their truckie and load the transport and they save it to their save file. So it's very good, very good. Yeah, Gnabby say, so your Demi or Chucky the other day, very slick and impressive. Yeah, I agree. I'm not involved in making Chucky, but I'm using it and I am the people.
Yeah,
we do
help and translate.
Yeah. From English to Swedish. We in the team. I think we have translated so much. They have to offer us a free, what do you call it? The
premium.
Premium, yeah. They, okay, I'm coming into the toll booth now. I'm diving slowly now. Here you can see my track. Damage of the track you have here. Damage on the trailer there. How much diesel I have in the tanks there. My current speed there. And if I use the speed holder, it will show in here. This is on my truck. And the weight, 44 ton. If I had to repair, this is where I come from. And this is where I'm going to. And how much money I will have for this transport. This is the distance to the when I go when I'm have to unload it. Real time 43 minutes. It's not the game time. It's the real time. And this is the time when I'm at this location. Grundzads is 11:49, my time, local time. And I have driven, since I started up again, I have driven 454 kilometers. So, that was a quick version of explaining the information you can see on the screen.
But I forgot to look about this number who's changing all the time behind the...
Oh, okay. Yeah, about the sprocket.
Damage. Mm-hmm. I don't know. For me, it's 5 at the moment.
Oh, 11 for me. But if I increase the speed, it's higher. And when slowing down, it will be lower. And Sweden, me talking about this number 9 here for me now. And when I slow down, it's 7, 4, and when I'm increasing my speed, it's also increasing. And we don't know what it is. I don't know.
Something to do with tire wear.
With what?
Tire wear.
Tire wear. It cannot. Oh, do you mean the faster I drive, the more? Okay.
I don't know. No.
I have no idea.
And now one stop down to 1.
Mm. If some of you in the stream now know what it is, you can please tell us. But Mr. Swede's guessing is, I think, very good. And you cannot click on it either. Shit, it is 30 here. Why is it 30? By some reason, it's 30 kilometers out from this toll booth. Make some error here. No, it was 80. mean, in resnick, I cannot pronounce the word. Okay, my friends. Hello, everyone viewing this channel. You are very welcome. I'm driving from Russia. Now I am in some other country, south of Russia. I don't know the name of the country. Sorry, but I'm going with the asphalt miller, 44 ton. To the town you can see on the blue part of the screen, south, you can see the, just under Vasa. And I have driving with my truck is a MAN GTX Euro 6. The how reason, but
how far have you left?
About 800. The reason why I'm driving this MAN instead of another is the sound from the engine. I like it so much.
Sound.
The sound, yeah. I like the sound, yeah. It's so groovy. The other is not so good as this. DAF, the DAF is also very good sound, I heard. But this is a dark, mooring sound that I like. And I can show you on the map where I am. I have no hurry to go. I will show you in a couple of seconds. So, and here you can see where I am and where I'm going. I'm going against Riga now, on the road called A12 and A6. There is a very interesting road just there, it's a curve, and then I go into Siaulia, I think it is, to Kaliningrad, and here is my goal, south of Elblag, is I don't know. So I have a couple of kilometers to go, as you can see. And I have my asphalt miller here. It's a big, heavy one. And I will be paid 80,000 euro. It's about $90,000 or $100,000. And it's very, very much in Japan. Yen. Millions and millions of yen. And I have my friend Mr. Swede also on this channel. He is driving his own truck. And we are using Discord.
Something.
Okay. We are using Discord to communicate.
Such a good app.
When you got it working?
But now I haven't had any issues hearing you since you fixed it.
Okay. Well, a little tip. If you have a headset and it's connected by USB, don't connect it via a USB hub. Connect it directly to the computer. And now I'm going to take a coffee.
I do have my connected through the hub.
Yeah, sometimes it's worked, but you have to take in also thinking about other things connected to the same hub. Like I have the camera, and I have the mouse, and sometimes it's not working together, and also the keyboard. So
I do have mouse and keyboard and
But you are lucky. I wasn't.
Yeah. But I don't know if I do have a wireless headset. I don't know if that's
that I don't have. No, I have a Kraken Kraken. It's a rather old headset, but good. I got it from my son, which passed away for 4 years ago. He don't use it anymore. USB overload. Yes, it was indeed. Indeed, it was.
Yeah.
I cannot remember what brand it was on the USB hub. I think it was a 7. You can connect 7 USB to this. I think it was D-Link. D-Link, I think it is, was. And I think D-Link is rather good.
Yeah, it's a quite big brand.
Yeah.
Especially routers and stuff like that.
Routers, I don't know.
The one I have now, no, that's not D-Link, but I have like a extender.
Yeah, I have one router, Asus router, the main router at home, connected to the broadband, 200 megabit. And then I have a smaller router connected to the computer and wireless to my TV box and to my laptop. I have also I cannot remember the brand of that router, but it works very good.
You mean for me, for example, I have fiber and I have my router.
Yeah.
So I can like have another router connected to that one.
Yes, you can.
Like have that like an extender.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think some of the routers you can connect the wireless together and they work together, but older one you cannot do that. And I have an older one, so I have a cable from the main router to this router.
Okay.
And by some weird thing, I could not connect it at the input. I have to put it and make it a switch. Oh. So I put it in the one of the output sockets. And it's okay, but then it is a switch, you know. But the wireless also worked in this secondary router. And I also have a switch at, so connected to the main router, and to the switch I connected my memory. It was an what you call it, an NAS. Network access, so I have a 5.2 teras hard drive working in mode 5, I think. So if one hard drive broke down, I can close it down and put a new one, and after a day everything is okay again. But if two hard drives at the same time crashed, then I am in trouble.
Oh, I tried with my router. I have a USB memory card, USB memory, but I don't know how to, if like say I'm gonna use it from my other laptop.
So you connect a USB memory to the router directly?
Yeah.
Can you do that?
And then, yeah, you're supposed to.
Do you have a USB connection to the router?
Yeah. Uh-huh. And then you should have something so you can
share.
Yeah. So you share that one. But I don't know what program I should have to, yeah, to see the files.
Yeah. I can do that from my NAS. I can connect a USB to that and share it to my computers, yeah, connected to the network. But I don't know how to do it when you connect your USB to the router. Then I have no idea about how to do that.
I do have a NSA.
NSA? Yes. I have a NSA connected to my.
Oh. But I really didn't think I had any use for it.
Yeah. Now I'm coming into Riga. Don't like roundabouts. I think they have many roundabouts in England.
A small one.
Yeah. And we have small ones in my town also.
Yeah, some of them are so small so you can drive over them.
Yeah, I can. Exactly. We have three or four small one and two large one. But we don't have any, not so many traffic lights. I think we have only two.
In my time, they removed them.
Oh, nice.
It's a very big town, but I think we had it in two places, but now it's one roundabout.
Before we have parking meters in my town, but they have removed it also and have the paper one with the clock. What do you call it?
Ah, yeah.
Yeah. So if you are parking, let's say at 12 o'clock, you put the timer on the 12, and then you have 2 hours to go to shopping and so. But we have a Mr. Parking Man checking that. I heard about one people connected to a little motor engine to the this timer. So whenever you see his where I park, if always 1 hour gone. When they park it.
Yeah.
But one parking guy or girl, I don't know, recognized this as cheating. And the police come and he got fined for that. Trying to cheat the parking meter. But the idea was very good. But no.
When I go to the other neighbor town, it's I use this application, SMS Park it's called.
Yeah, me too.
It's quite good.
I have the
and I just had I just had have to pay
oh, thank you.
Yeah, it's less than $1 for it.
Yeah. Felix hosted you is his name, but he's following me. Felix, thank you. Thank you very much. What is it called? Wait a little. I have to check another one thing in my phone here. There. I have a application called Parkster.
Yeah, I have that one too.
Yeah, it's very, very, very good, I think. And then if you don't have any money, you can park your car and you can look at the sign called, if you park here, you press the code 1234 and starting parking. And you pay after 1 month, you get the invoice how much to pay. Very, very good, I think it is. I don't know how it is in another countries. If you have an electronic parking meter or not, I don't know. So when I'm in my closest town called Sundsvall, when I park in the center of the town, I use this application in my phone and put in that now I'm starting parking, and then I can go into town 1 or 2 hours and come back to the car and say, okay, stop parking, bang, and then I got an invoice a month later. Very smooth, very good indeed. Five hundred kilometers to go.
23.
Well, now we have talked about parking meters and track. What should we talk about now?
Okay,
what are we going to talk? We have 7 viewers on the stream. And what do you want us to talk about? Not political, not private things. Do you have any ideas?
Depends how personal it is.
Just a minute. I have one stupid people here, don't know me. So Felix hosted you. Wow.
Can't hear you.
Can he not hear me?
No, I can't.
Felix hosted you with 217 viewers. Wow! That's lots of people. Thank you very much. Now I'm entering Litauen. I'm driving here with my MAN truck and I have an asphalt miller. And that was a very kind thing to do, Felix. Thank you very, very much for that. And welcome all to the stream. I can only see 5 of you just now, but I don't know how. It says many, many people, 217, but I cannot see that in my stream. But you are welcome. Everyone is welcome to my stream. Thank you very much. If you want to follow me, you can do that. Push the follow button and you will be following me. Thank you. I am from Sweden, the northern half of Sweden I am from. And I'm 67 years old. Yeah, you heard that. 67 years old. Soon I will be dead. Sorry. So
I have to follow another guy.
Please follow me now when I'm alive.
Oh, wow.
No jokes. Sorry.
We all will be dead. Someday.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah. Can you can include 2 game in one? You have the game you were talking about. Mr. Swede. Walking Dead, or what you called it.
7 Days to Die.
Yes. You can include that in this game, maybe.
Yeah.
When you're over 60 years old, you're out. No, I was joking only. Well, well, I have 447 kilometers to go before I am at my goal with the red flag.
And now I'm entering Poland.
Yeah, but why did the hosting said that he was hosted the stream with 217 viewers and I cannot see them? I don't know why.
I actually don't know how that works.
Zombie tracking. Yeah, I don't know why.
I have no idea either.
By the way, one or two more viewers is good enough for me. So we are, all of you are welcome to my stream. If you have any questions for me, you are free to put it in the stream. No political, no swearing, only kind. Here we are so kind to each other. Have you tested the sweaters I sent you yet?
I actually forgot that.
Haha. Grabby said they are still watching over on Felix's channel unless they choose to transfer over. Okay. I thought it was automatic transfer, but it was not. Ah, yeah. You have not done that. Should I be honest to you, I have not tested my Eurotrack sweater also.
Okay.
So I have to do that also. But I have to wash it first.
Yeah, same here.
Always wash a new things before using it, except yeah. Socks.
A little bit cold for teachers now. So.
Yeah. Not inside.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Have you cold inside your house?
Yeah, pretty cold. My wife is so hot. So.
Like you were married, Harry. It's hot.
Pretty cold, so.
Yeah, yeah.
No, but it's dependent.
It's good to have a hot wife. Yeah, I understand you. I'm only joking with you.
Yeah, I know. No, so yeah, it's in the bedroom. No heater on.
Okay. Yeah.
Before she goes to sleep, she opened the window.
Sometimes it's easier to sleep and it's a little cold. I also like it a little cold, but now I'm going a bit old and I'm inside my apartment all the time, so now I'm cold. I don't like it when it's cold, but before it was okay.
Yeah. But you don't have to pay as much as I do.
Maybe your... my rent is not so much as your payment for the house.
No. Miles to go.
Yeah. I have a guy here want to pass me. Jumbo. 44 ton is heavy. He has an engine chain. Next time I don't want to drive so heavy a trailer. Okay, I have 333 kilometers to go.
Groot. Yeah.
Yeah, Groot.
Grootsiats.
Something like that, yeah. Now I come into another country. I hope I have my papers ready now. The next one following me will be on the leaderboard for Stream Boss, and you can see on the right side of me. It's now just now is the Pyro is on the leaderboard, and the first people now following me or subscribing will be on the leaderboard on and remove Pyro from the leaderboard.
Am I on the leaderboard?
No, you are on my list of Mr. Swede sub resub times two, it says.
Yeah.
And the last one is Felix hosted you. His username is Felix hosted you. And also Victor from Denmark. And Mr. Swede. The next one will be on the leaderboard just to the right of my head. And remove Pyro from the list. And remember, it's free to follow me. You don't have to pay anything.
Just one click.
Yes, you're one click for to be famous. If you want to know anything about the track, you can ask me or Mr. Swede.
And we will not tell you.
It's a secret.
Yes.
No, we will try to answer your question as good as we can. We are not an expert, but we know something. You don't.
For example, yesterday I helped one friend with
installing
Chuck's book. It was an update this week, and it says offline, and couldn't figure it out, and I helped him to reinstall it and use this program called TB Cleaner, installed it again, same thing. But then after a while we come to the conclusion that it was, he had like a firewall program. And it was blocking Truxbook.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Just a click of a button and it worked.
Yeah. And if you are using, if you are using Trucky, remember start the Trucky before the simulator.
Yeah, best thing to have it on automatic.
Yeah. Start together with Windows, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Depends how much you drive and stuff. But
yeah. If you only drive one time a week, you don't have to have it on auto start.
Depends on your PC also.
Yeah.
Not good to have too many automatic starts.
Indeed. I have the backup.
I do have.
Yeah, I have a backup program saving the important files to another hard drive. And once a week it saves to the NAS. So remember, backup your computer, it will start working. It is not a guess, it's the truth. And then it's very, very good if you have a backup. Going to Kaliningrad now. Not in Kaliningrad, I'm going to Kaliningrad.
Are they still doing this Christmas event?
Yeah, I saw it when I started the simulator. I saw 15 or 15, not removed yet. I don't know how long time it will be there. Yeah, I want to do that also. I have to go to the bathroom. I will soon do that. Sorry, my friends, I have to go to the bathroom. I'll be back in about 1 minute. Please stand by. So, now I'm back.
Hey.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm looking sometimes one streamer called Aquaholic, and he is checking out many boats, small boats, and he said they have a day head. So maybe I was now at my day head.
Day head?
Day head, yeah. En liten toalett. Not.
I mean, okay, now.
It's a small toilet on board a little ship called day head. Then they have also master, what you call it, with a shower and so. But only to make number one and two, they have the day head. You can look, if you're interested, you can look at Aquaholic, his name is. And he is on many small ship called Sunseeker. The length of the ship is about 30-40 meters. Maximum 450 sometimes, and his YouTube name is Aquaholic. I subscribe on him. I don't like the water, but he's very interesting in showing other people around the ship. Cheerios, Toby. Kill that cat. Cold coffee. But I'm happy it is safe for some. Then I can It's okay. Traffic light going to be red. Shit, shit, shit. Why have a traffic light here? I don't want to get fined. I got it one time, I think it was the last stream before this. I got a big fine in going into, I think it was one of the roads or the bridge in Denmark. It was speed regulation there and I did not know that. Bing! A couple of thousand euros. Unnecessary. Before I joined this VTC I'm in now, I was driving too fast every time. I don't have any fines activated. I'm driving through red light and I'm driving too fast, and now I am in this VTC and the rules is you must have the fines on. So I'm very, what do you say, important for me not to speed. Coming into Kaliningrad, outside Kaliningrad now. I'm stopping here so I can see the traffic light. And you guys looking at this stream, if you are also driving Euro Truck Simulator or American Truck Simulator, try to drive as in real time. In real traffic, not speeding, not driving against red light. You feel it, I feel very good about it.
It's no race game.
No. Then you have F1 race game if you want to race.
On the arcade service.
Yeah, if you want to speed, yes. Thank you, Gnavist. Yeah, I have to pay. I think it was rather expensive. I cannot remember how much it was, but very expensive. So, taking document, drinking cold coffee. ~135 kilometers to go in real time, 8 minutes. that is a good thing. This tracking show you how long time you have to sit here. Agree, there's plenty of options for crazy driving for almost single day, yeah.
Both, I have to leave you now, I have to
okay.
go somewhere.
Yeah, yeah, see you.
See ya, bye guys.
And Ericsson, welcome. Mr. Swede have to go, so now I am alone at the Discord. But I have you, Ericsson. I have to follow the rules in speeding now, because I don't want to have any fine. I don't know if you get fine if you're speeding here, but I don't want to risk it. Wow, you knocked down those. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, I like sitting and driving here. Yeah, I like it very much. Before I was a senior citizen here now. 67 years old as I am today. I was a bus driver for 23 years. So I know how it is driving in my job. And that was sometimes not so good, but most of the time it was very, very good. Talking to the customers and driving them to the job in the morning and home in the evening, and the school girls and boys, driving them to school in the morning and home in the evening. So most of the time it was a very good job. The only thing, it was winter time. When it was icy and snowy, and you have the timetable, you have to hold it. Sometimes you give a damn in timetable, you cannot drive too fast, and you have to see that they come home in one piece. So sometimes you were very, very, very late. But better late and not coming home at all. But sometimes, I think it was a couple of times, it was too slippery. So I could not drive. They had to take a tow to help me. And I was not the only one some days. A couple of us was having problem to drive. It was too icy and too slippery. And the truck with sand was not close to us, so we have to wait for the guy to go to us and help us with sand. It was too icy. But summertimes it was nice, but hot. When I'm working, we don't have air condition in the buses. So it get very, very hot. But on the summer, the children was not at school, and We have nice driving then. Only grown-ups go to the work and go home after work. And on the middle of the day, the wives go to town and shopping and go home. And then on the evening, the working people was going home. And I have this work for 23 years. It was very good. I have about 60 kilometers to go in real time, 3 minutes. But driving a truck in real life, I haven't done that. Only one time for about 20 kilometers, trying only with an instructor. So that was very nice. It was loaded with sand. I think about 10-12 tons of sand. With the trailer was. But no more in real time, real life. And before that, I was driving a crane for about 7 years. And that was a good job. You come and worked 8 hours. Then you go home. And that work I liked very, very much. Oh, I can see the flag. Ah, nice. You can maybe pronounce the name here, maybe, of the town. Grudziquidz, or is it a Q? An A, maybe. Grudziadz. Grudziadz, maybe, yes. Yes. Only me, no one else in the town.
I am going in here. Oh, over there, maybe. Listen. Search spells. I'll look at the cables here when I disconnected it. Good. So, I have a stream for 2 hours. Excuse me. Am I going to drive anything more now? What do you think? A little short trip, maybe? We can choose... see where we are. We are near there. Empty palace. Too long to drive. It takes so long time. But we can use a trekkie to go to Poznan. Poznan is from this town. I have to write it down because my memory is not so good. Take a paper, and I'm taking a pen. And I am now in Grudzd. G-R-U-D-Z, and I'm going to Poznan, P-O-Z-N, I think it was, Poznan, yes, and escape, and I am now at a company called NCH. NCH. And if I go to Poznan, there you have it. I'm going to FCP. FCP. Now I'm going to use this. I'm going to save where I am. I'm going to save Trekkie. Save overwrite. Then I Alt D as Delta. Very important, you choose your username and the save file as Trekkie, and I want to go from GRU, there we have it, Grusdjak, and we have a company called NCH, And I want to go to POZN Poznan. And I go want to go to FCP. That is correct. And here I choose the load where I want to go. And I want to have electronics is good. Electronics. And this that this I don't have to change. These two. I don't have to change. And I want to have it high. And I add delivery. Now you can see where I'm going from, where I'm going to, how long it is, electronics. And this code is very important. If you are several of you driving in convoy, the other guys with a truckie also, they put in this code in their truckie up here. They put in their this unique code and then put import, and they will have the same here. And now it's very important. You have to update your save file. And the save file was truckie. So now it's finished. Now you're going to save and load, load, truckie, and load. So, and now you escape. So, voila, look here, electronic from Gosna, Poland to Poznan. And electronic, exactly as you choose when this. This is much better than the dispatcher. This is another software. This is much better. You put it in, yes. And I go into my track and close this. I don't need it. Now I go back into here. Choose this, and there you have it, electronics, accept. Now we are going to back up. Now we are going to have it, here you have the trailer waiting for us. It's so simple using Truckee. So I hope you like this Truckee, because I think it's a fantastic good software with this overlay you can use. And I hope you like it. I like it very much. The church bell is still working. So we are driving in Poland just now. Hurrah! Hooray! Agata, welcome to my stream, and thank you to the group, my following group. It's very nice having you here. I am driving in Poland just now, and I was telling my friends, and also you, maybe you can hear it, I am using the Trucky overlay, and also with you can make your own transport with Trucky. So if you are in one place and want to go to another place, you put it in from and to and what cargo you want. Voila, everything is okay. Load it in and you can start driving. Also, you can use the same code. It's unique for every time with your other friends in the convoy, so they will have the same a trailer, not the same as you. It's very, very cool indeed. So you can do it in the game without exiting the game. It is very, very, very nice. I can show you a little about it. I can park here, it's no problem. I park here at the side of the road. So, and hazard. So, hey, it was a signal. So, there you have, I press Alt D, Alt Delta. And this is a dispatcher, as you can say. In Swedish it's a speditör, but in English it's a dispatcher. You choose your game. It can also be ATS, American Truck Simulator. Your username. If you have many username, you can see, but you choose the username you have. You choose a save file. You have to save with your location before entering this. I have a special save file called Trucky. Select where you want to go from, the town. And what where from you have many different places you can load from. Choose where you want to go, town, and also what destination company when you want to deliver from. And your load, what you want to drive, load. Ice cream, coffee, helicopter, whatever you want. And if it's urgent, high load, very urgent, and you save it here. And then you have to save it into your save file as used here. You will also have a special code here. And this special code, the other guys put it in here, in your in your convoy, they put in this code. Everyone put this code in and import, load and save it to the save file. And everyone will have the same. This is name is Tracky. T-R-A-C-K-Y. Tracky. And it is so good, I think it. And when you are driving, you can see what track you have here. Track you have. Damage on your track. This I don't know what it is. Damage on your trailer. How much diesel you have in your tanks. How fast you are driving. And if you're driving via a speed thing, you can see what speed you have chosen. Your job, electronic, how much it is, 8 tons. Damage on the cargo, where you are going from, where are you going to, how much money you will get for the transport, how long many kilometers you have to go before you are at the finish. And this is very important, how long time in real time it will take. Not in game time, in real time. And I live in Sweden, it is 15:39 in Swedish time. And how long you have driven from you started this trip. So that's very good. Now we have a guy coming here. You can see this blue one. It's a Tonton. Yeah, yeah. Hello, hello. Yeah. I hope that is okay. Now I will continue my travel. If you have any question, maybe I can answer. Now, we have you as a leaderboard in the Chucky. In Stream Boss. It is Agata leading now in the Stream Boss, just to the right of my head. You have this leaderboard, and if you want to be in the leaderboard, you can follow me and you get points, and you can subscribe and you get more points, and you don't have to subscribe, but it's very fun if you do that. It will be good for me. For you who don't know me, my name is in game is City Look Sweden, and I live in Sweden, in the middle part of Sweden. And I have been driving for about 3 years with Euro Truck Simulator and also American Truck Simulator. But lately now I'm driving only Euro Truck Simulator and streaming. And after the stream, about 1 or 2 days, I will move this video to YouTube. So every video I have is on YouTube. And as I told my friends, I'm old. I'm 67 years old. And driving too fast, I can see. That's not good. And I love this game. It's a very, very nice game. And also I have a couple of friends. We can go driving a convoy, and truck is doing a very, very good job when we are going by a convoy, because I share this unique code for this transport to the other guys, and they will also have the same type of transport. Yes. Sometimes if you are using the built-in, you cannot go from certain places, but in Trucky you can. If it is a loading or unloading area, you can choose it. By the standard dispatch, you cannot. Even the smallest one you can choose. And Trucky is completely free to use. I am not involved anything in it, only translated to Swedish. But when I'm using it, I love it very, very much. It is one of the best add-on overlay. I said not add-on, it's an overlay to Euro Truck Simulator and American Truck Simulator. This truck is a static truck, not a people, or say a fire truck. Seven minutes, and then I will be at the unloading area. 7 minutes is a real time. Now you can see I put in 50 kilometers, no, 48 in the. So you can see that on the side there, it's 48. Now 70. Now I increase my speed. Oh, it's 69, but it's close to. That is my trip speed holder. Six minutes. You can check if you want. Take the timer and you will see it is about 6 minutes before I am at the finish point, the red flag. This will be the last transport I do for today. I have no special time a day when I start streaming, so to be sure, follow me, my stream, and you will be having a notice when I start streaming. Thanks for stream. I had to look at the road also. In case I don't get a chance later, the puppy is prepared this morning. Okay. Okay. Thank you much, Knabbist. You are a very good guy. And helped me many, many times. You know, Gnabbist, I will do something for you because I trust you very, very much, and you are with me so many, many times. I will. If you will. Wait a little. I do it like this. Forgive me, Gnabbist. I cannot find what I want to do. Now I know. Just a minute. So, my friend, where have I the mouse pointer? Where is the mouse pointer? There. So, Mr. Gnabbist, you are with me so many times when I'm driving, and you are so good, so I'm trusting you. I only do that to people I trust, remember that. Yeah. Now I enter Poznan with three players together. You can see that in upper middle that the track tell me that you in Poznan it's three other guys also playing your tech simulator. I as then also one of the facilities for Tracky, you get information when you enter a bigger town, how many other user it is in the town. Five kilometers to go. Too much braking. FCP I'm going to, and there you have FCP to the left. You can see it's there in red, FCP.